She was living in a single room with three other individuals.
And furthermore, Susan, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised to learn that all four of them habitually smoke marijuana cigarettes. Reefers.
From the world-famous Blackbird Studios, it's the Rave X Podcast. And now, Rave X.
Hey now, welcome to the show, or podcast, call it what you will. I'm your host, Spoonie Love from up above. Today we're going to talk about the story of the trailer park Dimebag. That's right, man. This is a funny story, and I've told this story a few times, and one of my friends said, you should put that on your podcast. So with that being said, kids, let's dive in. So this story takes place, man, a few years back when I lived in Jacksonville, Florida. There's another podcast I did called Welcome to Jacksonville. You should look for that one on YouTube or the Bandcamp, man, ravexmusic.bandcamp.com. Shameless plug. I had just gotten to Jacksonville, and I had no friends. I was there with my girlfriend at the time. Like I said, I had no friends. And, you know, I started this telemarketing job, man, and it was pretty cool. And I'm immediately starting to look around and see who can I be friends with, right? Like, who can I sort of hook up with, you know? When you move to a new town, it's like prison. You automatically have to shack up with people for, like, protection and to get the lay of the land and shit. I'm looking at this one dude, and he seems cool, so we start talking, you know, and I'm like, yeah, I'm a musician, I'm from Boston. He's like, oh, welcome to Jacksonville. I'm like, thanks. And then I start asking him, you know, like, what do you do for fun around here, blah, blah, blah. You know, we're making small talk. We're hanging out in front of this crappy, horrible $6.25 an hour telemarketing gig that I had. But it was the only gig that hired me, man. And if you've ever relocated to another town, you kind of take the first job that will offer you a paycheck, man, because you got bills to pay and stuff. So me and this dude, we're hanging out shooting the shit. Now, I had already been in Jacksonville about 2 weeks at the time, not really making any friends. So this guy was kind of my first contact and sort of connection in Jacksonville. He's a good guy, man, you know, but when I met him, it was kind of pre-Facebook, pre-cell phone stuff. So, you know, I kind of lost contact with him when I moved out of Jacksonville, man. I hope he's doing okay. He's a real good, solid, smart guy. The question I had for him was the question that I think any musician has when you get to a new town. ¿Dónde están las drogas? Now, for those of you who don't speak Latin, that means where's the drugs, man? Now, look, I'm not talking about hardcore drugs. You know that. Your boy Ravex doesn't get down with that. I ain't never done ecstasy or crack or heroin. That was never my bag, baby. I was always a fan of a little bit of weed and a little bit of whiskey, a couple of beers, fire up the amps, grab your goddamn guitar, and let's rock out with our rocks out, man. That's how we always did it. You didn't need no more than beer and whiskey and a little bit of weed. So we're talking, man, and I'm like, hey, I don't want to offend you or anything or imply that you look like the type of person who would know this, but you've lived in Jacksonville for quite some time, as you mentioned. Where can I get a little bit of weed from, brother? And he goes, oh, I didn't know what you were going to say. It was a little bit of weed. Yeah, okay, I can hook that up. And I'm like, Wayne, really? Okay, good, because I've gone like 2 weeks without some weed now. And he's like, yeah, no problem, man, no problem. So he's like, all right, look, I can't give you the guy's number. I kind of have to hook it up, but I got to be someplace. So let's do this. I'll have him come pick us up. He'll take us back to the trailer park. And the first thing that went through my head was trailer park. Now, I had been warned that there are parts of Jacksonville, Florida. I was on the west side of Jacksonville. And I had been warned that there are parts of Jacksonville that are real live Jerry Springer shit. Now, if you listen to this in Jacksonville, don't get mad at me. I got out of Jacksonville. You stayed there. But there really are some hardcore trailer park. You know, I hate to say white trash. That's kind of a little bit too harsh of a phrase, man. They're really nice people. But then again, in the ghetto, you got hood rats, right? So it takes all types. So anyway, he's hooking it up, and he's like, all right, man, you know, I'm going to call my buddy, and Rick's going to pick us up, man. He's gonna drop us off at the trailer park. He'll hook you up with whatever you need from there. And I'm like, all right. And what about you? He's like, I got to go someplace, man, so I'm going to leave you with Rick. And I'm like, okay, is it cool? And he says, yeah, Rick's a good guy, man. You'll be okay. He'll take care of you. Trust me. Now, granted, I don't know any of these people. I'm new in town. Now, the Great South, which Jacksonville was, it didn't even seem like North Florida. It felt like South Georgia, Alabama, stuff like that. You know, places like that. And they were not trying to hide their racism, man. That was the first thing that jumped out to me. Like, people would just say straight up, like, hey, man, are you one of those N-words from Boston? I can tell by your accent you're one of those N-words from Boston. And I got that a few times, but whatever. It doesn't faze your boy Rock Hard Rave X, you know. Now, I didn't know if he told his buddy that I was of the African-American persuasion. And I didn't know if that was going to affect how Rick treated me, because there were definitely, like I said, some people down there who were not down with the black folk. You know what I mean? So, his buddy Rick comes and picks us up, drives us back to the trailer park. Man, it wasn't that far, maybe 3 miles or so. And we're all shooting the shit, hanging out. You know, Rick seems like a nice guy. My buddy Wayne, he goes, all right, man, Rave, I think you'll be okay. I got to take off. I said, all right, I'll see you around. See you at work tomorrow. The first thing I noticed was this was a real live, dirty, filthy, low income trailer park, man. When you walked on the floor, it kind of sunk beneath your feet a little bit, man. Like the whole thing was made out of, like, you know, aluminum foil and cardboard or something. It was not the upper class trailer parks. And I've seen some of the upper class one, man. And those were really high end trailer parks, but not this one, my friends, not this one. Pretty small, close quarters. I walk in. He seems really cool, man. He offers me a beer, and I'm like, cool, I'll have a beer. Budweiser, which I hate that beer. His girlfriend's there, and she's like, hey, honey, how you doing? Oh, hey, who's your friend? Who's your friend? Straight out of, like, Central Casting. If you said, I want to film a movie about trailer park people, and you got these two, you'd go, it's a little on the nose, don't you think? You know what I mean? So we sit down, man, in his living room, and I notice he's got, like, a two-year-old daughter. And his two-year-old daughter was, like, playing with, like, three or four kittens. You know, there were always feral cats running around the trailer park. Like, the cat people would have cats, and they'd hook up with other cats and just have kittens. And they were just all over the place. I remember when we pulled it in a car and we turned into the trailer park, the headlights picked up, like, a half a dozen feral cats just running around in the trash. Really crazy. And she had some kittens, man, and she was playing with these kittens in a milk crate. Now, the little girl, her hair was kind of messy. She had dirt on her face. And, you know, she was, like, trying to stuff these kittens through the holes in the milk crates. It was really insane. You know, they had a TV sitting on top of a broken TV with aluminum foil around the antennas that was getting, like, a grainy black and white picture of, like, you know, Roseanne or something like that. So we're hanging out on the couch, and I'm looking around. There's trash. There's clothes that had been trampled into the floor so hard that the clothes were just part of the floor now, right? I look in the kitchen, which was to my right, and the trash can's overflowing. It had like a weird smell to it. But you know, man, I wanted this, you know, I wanted some weed. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I wanted some weed. And my next step was to find some musicians. This is what I do when I move around from town to town. Find some weed, find a coffee shop, find a place to get good tobacco, and then find some musicians, and the rest is history. Now, he leans over to me and he goes, all right, Rave, what do you need, man? I can get you a little bit of everything. And I said, well, not really into everything. I just want some straight up weed, my brother. That's all I need. And I'm willing to pay you, you know, $5 as a finder fee. And he goes, oh, you don't have to do that, man. Hold on. And he goes to the kitchen. He calls someone. I can't really hear him talking. And he goes, hey, Rave, how much you need? And I said, man, just like 20 or 25, whatever it is up here. You know, a couple of dime bags will get me through the month, really. He goes, all right. Goes back to the phone. All right, I'll see you in like whatever. Hangs up the phone, he comes back and he goes, man, I just called my boy Reggie. Reggie's going to hook you up with 2 dime bags, man, a 20 sack. Is that good? And I go, yeah, perfect. He goes, okay, man. He's got to get off work first, and then he's going to come by here. And I'm thinking, get off work? Like, this could take, like, what the heck? And I said, I don't want to seem ungrateful. And I go, how long are we talking here? And he goes, oh, man, it might be like 4 to 5 minutes to an hour. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to be sitting in this trailer park for 45 minutes to an hour for a couple of dime bags. But you know, beggars can't be choosy, right? So I'm sitting in this trailer park, man, and he's just talking to me, asking me about Boston. And I'm asking him about Jacksonville, Florida. His wife keeps running back and forth and talking about this tattoo she wants to get. And I am just blown away, man, because this was like full-on Jerry Springer stuff. And I couldn't believe these people actually existed. You know, you watch those daytime shows and you go, these people aren't real. These can't be real people, right? Oh, no, they're real. They're real, man. And you know what? Let me say this. They were really nice people. They never said, oh, you one of those black guys from... Like, no, they were just really cool, man. He gave me a beer. I know they didn't have much money. And his wife is asking me all these questions. Oh, I like your boots. Oh, you play guitar? Okay. Eventually, an hour came and went. And I'm saying, so, where's Reggie? And he goes, oh, he might be just a little bit longer, man. Now, I'm starting to get a bad feeling about this, man. I'm like, oh, my God, dude. Like, I don't think they were going to rip me off because they would have done it by now. You don't let someone sit in your house for an hour if you're going to rip them off. But still, then it becomes an hour and a half. And I'm going, so what's the deal with your boy Reggie? And he goes, hold on, man. I'll give him a call. I don't know if he got his cell phone. I'm going to give him a call. And he goes and he gives him a call and he comes back. He goes, oh, no, he said it'd be like another half hour, 20 minutes, man. And I'm like, all right. We get to the hour and 45-minute mark, and I'm starting to get antsy, dude. Like, I'm really starting to get antsy. I don't want to be in this trailer park anymore. I'm thinking I'm going to get some type of lice from the couch I was on. And I just really don't want to be there anymore. And I'm starting to think, well, how far of a walk is it back to my apartment? You know, maybe my girlfriend's off work now. I can call her, have her come pick me up. But I don't even know where we're at, dude. Like, I don't even know where to tell my girlfriend to pick me up, but I guess I just could have got the address from the people there, but the whole thing's crazy. I'm thinking I could just walk, catch a cab, I don't know. And then eventually we hit the 2 hour mark. And I'm waiting for a goddamn 20 sack in this trailer park. 2 hours. I see the headlights pull up in the trailer, right? Like the headlights come through the trailer. And the guy, you know, Rick, he goes, oh man, I think that's Reggie. He gets up, I give him the 20 bucks. He runs outside. He's outside for longer than usual, man. Maybe like 10 minutes. I don't know what they're talking about. I didn't want to peek through the blinds and be rude, so I just sit there, man. Finally, he comes back in. He hands me the bag, and he goes, here you go, man. And I look, and this was a small-ass 20 sack. Now, if you guys don't know this, the way it used to be back in the day when you don't have a steady connect is you go and you get a bag of weed, and it changes hands like 3 times. And every time it changes hands, somebody helps himself to a little bit of your sack. They used to call it pinching, right? If you were going to get a bag from somebody, you go, hey, man, make sure that motherfucker don't pinch my sack, which sounded gayer than I meant it. But yeah, you would you know, ask them to please not pinch the sack, you know, which means don't take your cut out of it. I'll smoke you up, but don't pinch it. By the time this 20 bag of... the stickiest of the ickiest had gotten to yours truly. It had been pinched, I could tell. It had been pinched like 3 times. So I look at it and I'm like, wow. And this wasn't even good weed. This is what we used to call in a day, shake. Like the bottom of the barrel weed, the kind of is loose weed, they packed that in there. This was definitely some shake, man. And I'm looking at it. I've already dedicated 2 hours of my life to this. And, you know, the guy from the trailer park, what am I calling him? Rick? He just sits down and starts watching TV, drinking his beer. His wife is like picking up some of the clothes on the floor, and I'm looking at this sack, and Rick goes, hey man, is that okay? And I go, it's a little light. And he goes, hey man, that's a trailer park, man. That's what, you know, you should see the dime bags in the trailer park. They're almost $5, not even 10. That's just how it is in Jacksonville, man. And I go, cool. And he goes, yeah, me and the missus, we ain't smoked weed in a long time, man. So now I feel like, well, these people don't have anything. They don't have a lot of money. He let me drink one of his last beers, and I go, well, what do you got? You got a pipe? You got a bong? He goes, man, I got a glass pipe, man. It's my favorite glass pipe. And I says, go get it. He goes and he gets his glass pipe. I take out some weed. I stuff it into the glass pipe, and I packed it pretty good, man. You know, I packed a decent amount of weed into that pipe that would, if he didn't burn it all in one day, would last him a couple of days. And he goes, oh, hell, Rave, thank you, man, thank you. I ain't had weed in such a long time. I love weed. He calls his wife. I think her name was Rose or something. She had a rose tattoo on her left shoulder. He calls her. Hey, Rose, Rave's gonna smoke us up. And I said, no, I don't even want any of it, man. This is all for you, buddy. You know, I got my stuff. And they're in the kitchen. The little girl's in the living room. They fire it up, and they were so happy. They're like, Rave, you're okay, man. If you need anything else, you call us, man. And I'm like, yeah, no problem. Thanks, buddy. So I call my girlfriend, I tell her to meet me at the corner of this street and that street. She's like, yeah, okay, I'll be there in 15 minutes, whatever. I walk out of the trailer park, past the trash and all the feral cats, and I get out to the corner of the two streets, and I'm waiting for her to come pick me up, and I'm looking down at this the weed that I got, and I said, damn, 2 hours, 20 bucks, and all I got myself was a trailer park dime bag. Wow! What a story, kids. Anyway, do me a favor, I got shit to do. Remember this. Drugs are bad, okay? Don't do drugs because they're bad. My name is Ravex. Enjoy yourself!
That
was the RaveX Podcast. Be sure to click like and subscribe. For podcasts, new music, and all things RaveX, go to youtube.com and search RaveX Music.